Okay, this one's full kindergarten. Question one. A technician is asked to streak plates with E. coli using the quadrant method. To start, the technician dips the sterile loop into the inoculant stock, that means where the cells are, and performs the first streak in quadrant one, that's the place you start, of the labeled agar plate. Organize the following. They're trying to see if you know how to do a streak plate, because if you don't know how to do a streak plate, you don't know how to do nothing. So they want to make sure you guys know how to do it. What's the first thing that you're going to do? Let's see. After you do quadrant one, I guess. So you're going to need to flame that loop to kill those cells. Boom. Second thing that you're going to need to do is let it cool. They got that in there. Then you need to open the plate just enough to insert the loop. Then you're going to have to streak from quadrant one. So you're dragging some cells from quadrant one into quadrant two. And then you're going to spread them around in quadrant two. Yeah, that's what you're doing. And this question asks, when preparing agar plates for bacterial culture, which is the next step after streaking the plates? What do you do after you streak the plates? Make sure the incubator temperature's correct and then place them right side up in the stinkubator. Nah, they don't go right side up, they go upside down. Otherwise, you get the condensation on them and they can drown. So we want to confirm the stinkubator temperature's correct and then place them upside down. Yeah, you guys know this. What's the purpose of the streak plate method? Why do you even do it? Is it to allow more bacteria to spread across the plate? No. Is it to provide four equal parts for the bacteria to grow? No. You just spread them all around if you wanted to do that. It's to dilute out individual bacterial cells, leading to isolated colonies. That's the whole purpose of doing the streak plate, is to get isolated colonies, because you need isolated colonies in order to do stuff. So that's the first one I've seen where they give you the option of all the above, and that's not the right one. So that's interesting. Take note. Next, Bradford assay. So we did this in in applied chemistry. This is how to see how much proteins in milk or in anything else. And what you do is you take test tubes, you take one of these 96 well plates, which has a bunch of test tubes built into it, and you add this chemical called Bradford reagent to your solution that you're trying to measure the protein concentration in. And Bradford reagent reacts with protein to make a blue color. So the more protein there is in your sample, the bluer it is. So this question says blah, 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 blah. But really, all you need to see is which of the sample rows most likely contains the control. You don't even need to worry about what control means here, or 0 micrograms per microliter of protein. Yeah? So which one of these has no protein? Surely row A has no protein in it because it's clear. Surely row B has the most protein in it because it's the bluest. So, I hope you guys found this one full kindergarten because test skills and that kind of your deal is biotechnology skills. Ooh.